Okay, let's give you guys some practice now. So work out this whole length here, from here all the way to back to here. So work out that length. So we've seen this before. So if you don't understand this, track back to one of the early videos, and the parametric equations are given by this. Okay, so work out this length. So press pause and have a go. Okay, so to work out this, we need to establish the limits. We need to establish A and B. So when time equals zero, try and find out when time equals zero, where will it start? So if you do this, time equals zero. So hang on. So time equals zero, put it into here. That would then tell you the x location, and then put zero into here. That will then give you the y location. So when time equals zero, the starting position would be 1, 0, 1, 0. So the starting position is here. But then we need to work out this total length. But rather than working out the whole total length, let's just concentrate on a quarter of a length. Okay, so this is start when time equals zero. We need to find out what time it will be when it gets to this stage. So the time it will get to this stage will be pi over 2. So now we know that we need to integrate it from time. Remember, we're doing it with respect to time. We need to integrate it from time equals zero to time equals to time equals pi over 2. Pi over 2. So we need to evaluate this. Okay, so that will then take us to this. So a quarter of that length is us taking the integral from 0 to pi over 2. And then it boils down to us evaluating this. But looking at this, we need to work out dx by dt, and we need to work out dy by dt. So looking at the original parametric equations, that's this, that's your x coordinate, that this is your y. So we need to evaluate this, but looking at this, we need to find dx by dt. So dx by dt is given by this. It's given by that. When you square it, it will then give you this. So we need to evaluate this. Looking at this, we need to work out dy by dt. So we need to look at this, differentiate it. Dy by dt equals this. So then we need to square it. So that will then give us this. So now we can put this back into here. And then we need to put this back into here. Okay, so that will then take us to here. That will then take us to here. But don't forget, that will ultimately take us to here. And then this thing here equals 1. So this whole thing here will then take us to here. So now tidy this up. That will then give you this. And now we just need to integrate this. When you integrate, try to look for something that's the exact derivative of another thing. So if you look at this here, cos t here is the exact derivative of sine t. So hang on. So we need to integrate this. So we are looking for something in such a way that when you differentiate it, it will then give you this whole thing here. Well, because this is the exact derivative of this, let's make our guess to be sine squared t. Now, when you differentiate sine squared t, it will give you two sine t, and then you've got to times it with the derivative of the bubble. I'm explaining it badly. Bear with me. We need to search for something in such a way that when you differentiate it, it will give you this. But because cos is the exact derivative of sine, we can make this to be our initial guess. Sine t squared. Make this to be your initial guess. That's the same as sine squared t. When you differentiate this, it will be this. It would be 2 sine t, and then we've got to times the derivative of the bubble itself, so that would be cos t. You see, when you make this to be your initial guess, differentiate it, it will give you this thing here. It will give you this thing here. But now negate the 2, so make the adjustment to our initial guess, and then that would then negate the 2, but then you want the 3. So times this by 3. Times this by 3. Well, when you integrate this, it will then give you this. Okay, think about it. So when you integrate this, it will give you this. So now from here to here, so that's really us doing this. Put this into here, that will then give you this. Put this into here, that will then give you this. So blah blah, L equals 6. So the whole length equals 6. Okay, that's your final answer.